Hey, this is YBR with Beam and G Drive, and today, this is part 2 out of 2 where we figure out what is the slowest car in the game. In the first video, we did the fast half of the vehicles. For this video, we're going to be doing the slow half of the vehicles. And we're going to start with either the Barstow or the Moonhawk. Now, you look at the Barstow, and it looks faster than the Moonhawk. It just has a more sporty appearance to it. The thing is the Moonhawk's inline 6 has 149 horsepower. The Barstow only has 116. So the Barstow's probably going to be slower when we want to do the fastest option currently available, which is going to be the Moonhawk. And since it's an older car, we will get it in automatic. And one thing that's kind of neat about this video is even though it's a part 2, you don't need to watch part 1 first. Because we have it split up pretty well, where I think most of the cars I'm driving are going to be slower than the ones in part 1. So if you just want to see the slowest of the slow, just watch this one. If you want to see the fastest of the slow, well, check out part 1. But you could do it in either order. Although we are going from what I think would be fastest to slowest. So we got a time of 17.555, which is actually way faster than I expected. That's faster than a handful of cars we already tested, and it ends up being in the top 10 fastest times we've done so far. I did not expect that at all. If I knew it was going to be this fast, it would have been in the first video, because that's very impressive. But what I think it is I never really paid attention to the difference between the Barstow and the Moonhawk. I always just thought, oh, they have about the same engine, and I usually drive the Barstow, so I think, oh, this one has 116 horsepower, but no, it actually has 35 horsepower more than this one. I don't think this one's going to surprise me. I think this one's going to squarely be around 18 seconds, which will put it in competition for the slowest production vehicle we've driven so far. I believe the slowest we've driven was the ETK iSeries at 18.1. So if we can get in the 18s, this is exactly where I expect it to be. Although it is getting pretty close to that ETK time. Let's see, 18.004. So it's definitely on the slower side, but it is a little bit faster than some other vehicles we tested, like the Tograk and the iSeries. Now, there are some non-production vehicles that are slower, but I'm just focused on production right now. Next up, we're going to kind of change categories. We're going to go to the truck and SUV category. So this is the D-Series, H-Series, Roamer, and Hopper. And I think out of these choices, the Roamer will probably be the fastest one, and I'll explain why when we select the slower ones. And for the Roamer, we are going to use the i6 four-wheel drive manual configuration. And I know in some situations, all-wheel drive could lead to a better overall time in the quarter mile, but that's only if the vehicle is actually able to take advantage of the all-wheel drive capabilities. This vehicle doesn't have enough power for it to make a difference. It'll launch just as hard with a rear-wheel drive or all-wheel drive configuration, but the all-wheel drive adds extra weight, which means in the end, it'll be a little bit slower. And we have a time of 17.677. That's another time that's quite a bit faster than I expected. That's about the same time as the Moonhawk we were driving a second ago to give you comparisons, just a smidge slower than that. And now there's another one of the Roamer we're going to drive, and this one should be a decent bit slower. This is the Adventure version. And the Adventure version is not a production vehicle. This is a modified one because obviously, can you imagine an SUV coming looking like this from the factory? That'd be amazing, but it ain't going to happen. So with this version, it has a lot of off-road accessories. One of the most noticeable things, though, is it's slower in a straight line compared to the Roamer we were driving earlier. In fact, it's barely going to reach 60 miles per hour before it gets to the end of the quarter mile. And a time of 20.407 would make it the slowest vehicle we've driven so far, excluding the ridiculous skid plate COVID, which takes forever to do a quarter mile. Next up, we're going to go with the Ibishu Hopper. And I think the Hopper is going to be slower than the Roamer because at its slowest, it only has an inline 4 engine. So we have four options here. We have the XT4, LXT4, and the Cop one. So we're going to go with the LXT4 because it is the heaviest one. And the Hopper does have some other configurations that are more off-road focused. And you might think, oh, those will be slower like the version of the Roamer we were just driving, but that's not the case because all those guys have the bigger engine. And that should be enough to make it faster than any inline 4 Hopper because the inline 4 is a lot slower than any of these 6-cylinder engines. So we got a time of 17.972. Basically the same time we got with the Barstow. So again, it's on the lower end, but there are a handful of vehicles that are a little bit slower than it. All right. Next, we're going to go to the D-Series, and I think the D-Series will be slower than the Hopper and the Roamer, because some versions of the D-Series can get really heavy. And they don't always get an engine upgrade in that situation, so there are some big trucks with relatively small engines. So there's a handful of vehicles I want to try out. The first is the D15 Fleet Extended Cab, which is the heaviest version you can get with the 165 horsepower engine. And this very well could be the very first time I've ever driven this specific configuration of the vehicle in a video before, because I don't remember driving it. So this does have a manual transmission in it, which definitely helps in this situation. If it was automatic, it would probably add another second or two to the time, but with the manual, it actually got a little bit of pep to it, and it's going to get across the line in a time of 18.022, which I believe is the slowest production vehicle we've driven so far this video. Yeah, so we're actually exactly where we want to be, but there are a couple other configurations I want to test for the D-Series that could be even slower. For example, there's this weird one called the Kentark D10 V8 four-wheel drive. And this one does have an engine upgrade over the one we have. It has 217 horsepower, where the D35 we were just driving had 165, but it's automatic and it weighs more than the one we were just driving. Those two combined can make it slower than the truck we were just driving. But there's only one way to know for certain, and that is to test it. So this will be really interesting, because this is a situation where more horsepower might actually mean you get a slower car. Oh, and I do like the color on this thing. That two-tone color is nice. Except I don't like the black around the bottom. That doesn't look that good. So this thing is going slower than the previous D-Series. I can tell because it just now reached 60 miles per hour in about 14 seconds. So this is going to be much slower. Oh yeah, that's a lot slower. 19.758, almost 2 seconds slower than the one we were driving before. Now there are a couple more that I want to test as well. First is the D35 diesel V8 crew cab dually. Now this is interesting because it only has 190 horsepower, but it has 413 foot-pounds of torque. So for this big old truck, I don't know what kind of stats it'll actually get. And one thing I like about driving a diesel like this is when you hold the accelerator, you just hear the turbo is spooled and ready to go, and then you launch. And it has actually a pretty good launch. The gearing on this thing is much, much better. That plus, never underestimate the power of torque. The torque can move the weight, no problem. That's going to be faster than any of the trucks we've driven so far, so that one's basically irrelevant because it's not slower. We only want to focus on the slowest. Now there is one more D-Series we're gonna drive. This one is not a production vehicle though, or at least it better not be, because this is the D35 Pig. And you wouldn't expect it to be that slow. There's not that much weight to it. It has the doors removed for lightweightness and such, but the gearing on it is made for off-roading. So if you take it to a drag strip, like we're doing right here, you will see the gearing can really hold it back, and it makes simple 0 to 60 time take well over 15 seconds, because there's 15 seconds and we're not at 60 yet. And 60, not yet. We didn't even get to 60 miles per hour in the quarter mile. It basically takes 30 seconds to get to 60 miles per hour, it feels like. And that time right there puts it as the slowest vehicle we've tested overall, excluding, of course, the skid plate once more, because that guy's just ridiculous. Rounding out the regular truck and SUV category, we have the 8 Series. And I think the H-Series is going to be slowest because it can get really heavy. The truck we were driving was like 6,000 pounds. This thing can get over 8,000 pounds. For example, it has the ambulance. Is the ambulance a stock vehicle? Definitely debatable. Because I'm sure if you actually have a legitimate lead for an ambulance, you can go and buy them all day. But a normal person, they probably can't buy an ambulance easily. So just to make things all fair and equal, we will test the ambulance and then also a more normal version of the H-Series. And because I can, the siren goes on. Everybody knows an ambulance drives faster when the siren is on. And actually, right out of the gate, this thing is faster than I expected. It's got 0 to 60 of like 11 seconds at 8,000 pounds with only like 280 horsepower. This thing is surprising. 18.743. Now that would be slower for the D-Series if we just had the first one we tested, but then the Kentark came in and ruined all of my guesses by being super duper slow. Alright, next up, we're going to go with a very normal version though, which would be something like the H15 Vanster long wheelbase. There's also the H25, but that one gets an engine upgrade, so I think that one would end up being faster. And this is another vehicle where you don't see it on camera that often. I think the only time I had this one in a video was when the long wheelbase configuration was added, and I used it to show you what the long wheelbase looked like compared to the normal wheelbase. And off of the line, it actually feels about the same speed as the ambulance. I legitimately can't tell which is faster, which is slower. It's gonna be really, really close, 18.603, so it's a tenth of a second faster than an ambulance. Seriously, that ambulance's time is a bit crazy. How are ambulances so fast? That's only 237 horsepower? And that's 8,000 pounds? Those statistics don't make sense, because this one has 20 horsepower less, but 3,000 pounds less, and it's a tenth of a second faster? What? I'm thinking the engine listed here could be incorrect. It does have 40 more foot-pounds of torque, but again, that doesn't seem like it could be enough. I'm going to have to do some further research on this later on. But next up, we need to take a look at the Fantastic, because this guy is a complete and utter joke when you take him to the drag strip. It's also a vehicle you would never normally take to the drag strip because it's made for off-roading. Look at the suspension dip as we accelerate right there. It didn't even accelerate hard, but it dipped. Here's the thing about this guy though. The gearing is awful for doing something like this. This thing is made for going into low gear and doing some mad off-roading. Doing a drag race like this, well, we're like topped out at 35 miles per hour. It's just ever so slightly going faster than that. That is absurdly slow. That is almost as slow as the skid plate Covet from the first video, which only had two out of its four wheels installed. This thing had all four wheels and it almost took 30 seconds to do a quarter mile. My goodness. And again, not a stock vehicle though, so that's just kind of a with an asterisk on it. Now that's all of the truck and SUV category, so now we're going to go back to the old car category. I know this thing's all a little bit of a mess on things, because honestly, the top half of the vehicles I'm familiar with, because I choose the fast vehicles, and the bottom half, they're slow. I don't drive them anyway, so I have no idea which ones are faster and which ones are slower. But looking at this thing here, you know what looks pretty slow to me is the Miramar with the base Miramatic transmission. And honestly, I'm asking myself, can this really be slower than an ambulance? I think it'll be really close, but it has to be faster because it's so lightweight. It only weighs like 2,300 pounds. That's a quarter of the weight almost of the ambulance. That has to count for something, but oh man, this is gonna be really, really close. And the clock says it's a half second faster. Congratulations. You're faster than the ambulance, and you're just a little bit slower than the D-Series we got. That was the Fleet Edition, I think. Next up, we are gonna go with another regular vehicle, the Burnside Special, and we're gonna get the Dualmatic, which is the worst transmission option available. And I think it'll be slower than the Miramar because it only has a two-speed automatic transmission. Two-speed. We're gonna shift one time in this whole drag strip. Look at how long this first gear is. It goes all the way up to like 70 miles per hour, it looks like. That's just crazy. And then even though it has a much bigger engine, that transmission is definitely going to hold it back. So what kind of time are we going to get? We're going to get a time of 18.212, which is basically identical to the Miramar. They could beat each other any day in a drag race. It just depends on how the driver is flooring it. Next up, we're going to go to the... Ooh, you know what? This one might actually end up being faster than the Burnside Special now that I look at it, but we're going to go with the Blue Buck, and there are a handful of Blue Bucks we could choose. We got the four-door, the two-door, and even the taxi version, which is just a paint job on the four-door, which is heavier than the two-door, so I'm thinking four-door automatic. So this should be interesting, because it's 10 years newer than the Burnside Special, but it doesn't have a V8 engine in its slowest configuration. This is an inline-six engine. So is it going to be faster or is it going to be slower? I'm really like 60-40 split. 60% of me says, yeah, it's going to be slower. 40% says it'll be faster just because it's so much newer. And the answer is, it is slower by about 0.2 seconds. So I made the correct choice in doing this one after. Next up, we're going to go with another regular vehicle. Oh goodness. We're going to go with the Bruckle Legrand, who I kind of forgot about, but thankfully, it has a really low-powered engine, right? Yeah, 92 horsepower on 3,000 pounds. It'll be close. And this is another vehicle where I really don't know what to expect. Because you look at it and you think, how can it possibly be slower than the vehicles we're driving? But then you look at the statistics and you're like, well, it has under 100 horsepower, and it weighs like 3,000 pounds, and it has a really junky automatic transmission? It might be pretty slow after all. And looking at the time here, it is slow. There's 19.399. That is almost the slowest production vehicle we've driven, except for that stupid Kentark who's so slow for some reason. All right, who we got next? Next up, we got the Pickle. And for the Pickle, we're going to go with the 110A. This one pairs the slowest engine with the automatic transmission. And the slowest engine has, I think, 37 horsepower. That's not a lot of power. I'm expecting this to be even slower than the Kentark, who's just been sitting as the slowest vehicle for way too long. And yeah, this thing is going very, very slow, and it's going to take the crown. 19, 20, 21.535. Yep, that is the slowest. Next up, we are going to go to the Bishu Pigeon. And on the Pigeon, we're going to choose the van because that is the heaviest configuration out of the bunch that is available from the factory. And you know how I was complaining about the Pickle, how he only had like 37 horsepower? Here's a fun fact for you. The Pigeon has 10 horsepower less, but it's also a little bit lighter weight. I still think it'll be slower, but it should be pretty close. It actually is feeling faster, but feelings can easily be deceptive. It could just be it has a really aerodynamic look to it, makes it cut through the air. In reality, it's not going that fast. I don't know. It's going to be really close at the time of 21.686. So about 2/10 of a second slower than the Pickle. Now we're going to go to the guys everybody knows is slow. We're going to go to the T-Series, and then we'll go to the Wentworth. For the T-Series, out of all these options, the slowest version is probably going to be the T75 Cement Mixer Upfit, because it's the heaviest one there is. Nothing's heavier than him. And it's kind of weird to classify this as a production vehicle or not. It's like the ambulance, where you can easily go and buy a cement mixer that's been on a production line and it's identical to 100 other ones. But it's also not produced officially that way out of the factory originally. They'd probably get a T-Series and then an external company would add in the cement mixer parts. So it's like, yeah, it's production-ish. So again, we're going to do two tests on this one. We're going to do the production version, not by gravel, and then the production version by gravel. And just as we would expect, slowest vehicle yet with a time of 26.018. So that's the asterisk time, though. You know, it's not quite official. For the regular version of the vehicle, we're going to go with the T75 base because it has the extra wheels in the back and still has the worst engine option available. This will still be slower than the Pigeon. I would be absolutely shocked if this somehow ends up being faster than the Pigeon, especially with this transmission. It just has to shift so much. I think it could actually be faster if you were to skip a gear in this situation, because the extra length would be beneficial because we're not towing a lot of weight. But as I said in the very first video, we keep it as simple as possible. We let the transmission do the shifting, and all I do is hold the accelerator down to get a time of 23.657. So that's the slowest full production vehicle we've got so far. And now, the final vehicle we're going to be testing is the Wentworth DT40L. And just for fun, we'll get the Zebra version, which is basically identical to the base, but it has a cool looking paint job on it. And I expect this to be the slowest production vehicle. I know it's not technically a production because it's the Zebra Tories version, but it's basically identical to the other one, and it is not going very fast. This thing feels almost as slow as the ridiculous Vantastic we were driving earlier, which took almost the whole 30 seconds. Almost. It's going to be a little bit faster than that, but not by much. There's 20 seconds passing us by. We're still going up to 51 miles per hour, a time of 26.351. So there's the time. Now we need to look over these stats and really figure out what was the slowest, what was the least slow. And the best way to do that, actually, is we go ahead and go back to the menus. And then if we go back to the time trial menu, we got this nice little display that shows us all of the ratings. So first we're going to focus on the production vehicles. Then we're going to take a look at the aftermarket versions. So the slowest production vehicle, kind of as you'd expect, is the Wentworth DT40L. It's a bus. Of course, it's going to be the slowest production vehicle. It makes sense. Followed by, again, pretty predictable, the T-Series. It's a big, fat, big rig. It's going to be slow, but it can tow a lot of stuff. And then we got the pigeon. Yeah, it tips over so much, you can't have it be that fast in a straight line. And then the pickle, which is just the old economy car. It makes sense. And then we have the D series. This is one of those ones where I did not expect it to be that slow. Like, that is so much slower than you would expect because it's a modern-ish pickup truck, yet it almost took 20 seconds with this configuration. It sucks. Is Kentark stock or is it aftermarket? I don't know, but I'm counting it as stock. I think it's like a production version. And then we got the LeGrand base. This is another one where it's like, what? It's that slow? LeGrand is so new compared to some of these other vehicles, yet it's that slow. Like, some of the things that are faster than it are the H15 Vanster with the long wheelbase. How is that faster? I don't know, but it is. The Blue Buck. And then we got the Miramar. Those two are actually a bigger gap than I thought. I thought they would be neck and neck, but the Blue Buck is easily slower. Then we got the Special. It just seems weird to call it Special, but that's what it says. It's the Special. It's the Burnside Special, who ended up being faster than I expected again because he is a dual-matic. That's a two-speed transmission. That's two gears and it did that. I-Series, much slower than expected. It's another modern car that just, it has so many configurations options. There's going to be one with a junk engine in it, basically. And then the Tograk, it's a crossover. Who cares? That's an extra D-Series. We got the Barstow coming in right about what you would expect it to be. Although, man, that Tograk is slow, seeing that it's slower than an inline six Barstow. Wow. And then we have the Hopper. That's about what you'd expect it to be. It's an off-road focused vehicle. And we have another Tograk. We can ignore that Tograk because we already saw the other one. The Pessima. Considering this is just an older economy car, it's surprisingly fast, I think. And up here, the Vivas. See, why would you ever get the Tograk when you could get the Vivas? Then we have the Covet, which that did a pretty well showing, actually. Again, it's an older car, but it did well. The Roamer, big fat SUV. Pretty surprising, though. It's almost in the top 10 fastest. Pessima 1.8 DX, it's a modern economy car. That's about where you'd expect it to be. Moonhawk Inline 6. This guy surprised me. With the Barstow being like 5 seconds slower, you would never expect this guy to be that much better than the Barstow. Now we're in the top 10s. We can ignore that pickup because that was an extra test. Then the old Pessima. Yep, the old Pessima is faster than the new Pessima. How funny is that? Then we have the Sunburst with the CVT. And I'm pretty sure the CVT is slower than the manual. But it's a nice modern car, so it's decently fast. 200BX, it's slower, but it's a sports car. Or it's a compact car according to the game, but it's a sports car to me, so it's going to be pretty fast. And the power of a V8 is shown with the Gravel Grand Marshal right there. And then we have, what's next? The SBR4. This is kind of surprising. I thought this would be like the fastest vehicle at first, because you look at it, it's a modern, fast car with a rear mid-engine configuration, but no, it's slower than a handful of vehicles. We got the 800 series being faster than it. It's a four-door wagon with a diesel engine, and it's somehow faster. I don't know how, but it is. And we have the Bolide. That makes sense. It's a supercar. And then we have the K series. Somehow, that ended up being the fastest slow vehicle. And it's kind of funny because you can look at this in two ways. You have two results you can see. What is the slowest vehicle? Straight up. There you go. There's the answer for that. And then you also have, well, what's the fastest slow vehicle? So this is the fastest slow vehicle because you can't get a K-Series that's slower than it, but you can't get a vehicle that's faster than it that comes with it for a different vehicle kind. Now, as for the ones that get the asterisk, we're just going to point out some of the outliers like the skid plate. 32 seconds for a quarter mile. That is pathetic. When I was driving it, I felt like I could run a faster one. I know I couldn't, but I felt like I could. And then we got the Vantastic. Same deal. That thing was so slow. And it had all four wheels. What the heck? And we got the Cement Mixer. Somehow the Cement Mixer was faster than the Vantastic. Yeah, I don't know how that happened, but it did. And then we also have the D35 Pig, another off-road focused vehicle that is pretty slow because of that. Same goes for the Roamer. And there's a big gap between these two. You notice, like, in the start and in the end, there's where the big gaps are. We have, like, a lot of gaps here, and then it kind of tightens up through the middle section, all real close, and then big gaps again near the end. And then what else do we got that is interesting to point out? Oh, the Beater! That's surprising. It looks like he's going to blow up any second, but he's faster than a handful of other vehicles. He's faster than the D-Series, even. Don't ask me how that happened. The Ambulance! How the heck is the Ambulance so fast? What the heck? An 18-second time. Ambulances are crazy, man. Making no sense over there. And I think that's going to do it for this video. There's one more thing that's kind of funny to look at, and that's the fact that the slowest version of the 800 was a drift version. What are you doing, drift version? I don't know. So anyways, that's going to do it for this video. Till next time, this has been YBR. And remember, if you like or dislike this video, I will know. I can tell by how fast the vehicles are. So do the right thing, and I'll see you next time.